If you watched my first tips video on how to use Adobe Premiere Elements, stick around, there's more. Tip number 6, write a short script when recording critical sound bites. The example I'm going to use here is a small tutorial on how to switch copper pipes. The video is about a minute and a half long, so that means I've got very little time to say a lot. I found it's easier to write a script. In Microsoft Word or whatever, just capture the key sentences that you want to say. Then when you're capturing your narration track, just read it as naturally as you can. Tip 7, how do you capture narration? There's a built-in tool inside of Adobe Premiere Elements. I'd be curious to see how many people know about this tool. Post a comment if you do. Under the Tools menu, there is a tool called Narration. How this tool works is it simply captures the audio as you read your script, and it places in the narration track automatically. Be careful though, if you click outside this window, it will split the tracks for you automatically, and you may have to piece them together a little later on. I'll show you an advantage of why you want one giant narration track. So what I'm going to do is hit the record button. I have 3 seconds to clear my throat and start reading. It will also play the video in the background. Make sure audio is muted while recording, otherwise you get some nasty feedback through your speakers. 3, 2, 1. Sweating copper pipes is easy.
Here's how.
First, cut the pipes to length using a hacksaw or pipe cutter. Make sure the pipe is cut longer before inserting into the fitting. Next, you gotta get your pipes cleaned.
Get some sandpaper and scuff off the surface.
Now, I'm not gonna read the entire thing here, I think you get the idea. So when I hit the stop button, it will add that narration track right to my video. So what this looks like is, let's hit done, and I'll crank up my audio here. Cutting copper pipes is easy. Here's how. First, cut the pipes to length using a hacksaw or pipe cutter. Make sure the pipe is cut long. Now, the video doesn't actually match the audio, and I'll show you a trick on how to handle that in just a second. Tip number 8. Let me guess. You stuttered, you got some gum smacking, maybe you cleared your throat and you want to clean that up in Audacity, or maybe you want to brighten up the sound levels. There's a tool out there called Audacity. You can use it for free, and it's a wonderful tool for doing audio editing. Let's see how. Now we're in Audacity, and I've simply opened up the narration file that I just created. This is actually a different one that I created previously that has all of the sound bites captured. What I like to do is expand this so I can get a good idea of all of the waveforms and see where I'm doing some heavy breathing, maybe some gum smacking. It gives me a chance to clean all of this up. Couple things that you can do in this. This is not going to be a tutorial on Audacity, but you can do things like noise removal. You can do some equalization to brighten up your voice, and you can even do some amplification to help reduce some of these large spikes and things that you have. Once that this is created and you export this to a WAV file, it will automatically import itself back into Adobe Premiere Elements. Tip number 9. Now that you have your narration track cleaned up and you probably have some nice soundtracks, how do you adjust all of these tracks together so they don't overpower each other? Now it's time to do some final mixing. On audio 2, I've got a cute guitar track. On my narration is the narration that we just worked on, and I've got another soundtrack acting as background. Problem is when I play it,
sweating copper pipes is easy.
The music is overpowering the voice. And when I get to the guitar,
first cut the pipes to length using a hacksaw or pipe cutter. Make sure
it's way too loud and it's in the wrong spot. So how do you fix all this stuff easily? Well, if you haven't found it yet, there's a tool under Tools called Audio Mixer. And what this allows you to do is change the audio levels over time. But there's one small thing that you have to do before you get to this. Let me close this down. Go to your preferences, go to your audio, and this right here, what says maximum time, milliseconds, change that to about 500. Otherwise, you're gonna get a million little edit points down in your sound levels. It's very, very difficult to edit. 500 seems to be about good for me. All right, let's see the audio mixer in action. What I'm going to do is I'm gonna crank down my guitar, which is on audio 2. I'm going to leave the narration and I'm going to leave the soundtrack, but I'm going to quickly back the soundtrack off when the music or when the narration actually starts. So hit the play button and start tickling these little volume levels.
Sweating copper pipes is easy. Here's how. First, cut the pipes to length using a hacksaw or pipe cutter. Make sure to cut the pipe length longer for insertion into the fitting. Next, you gotta get your pipes cleaned. Get some sandpaper and stuff the surfaces
of the
pipe
for now.
And the fitting.
Let me hit the stop button. And notice what happens. It adds all these little volume controls for me. So if I dance my cursor back and forth, let's expand everything so you can see. Notice how the audio levels are going to change. So it remembered all that for me. Now, it didn't get it right. That's why I got to manually edit things. Now, notice all these little dots in here, these edit points. If I didn't change my setting earlier that I showed you up under the preferences, from whatever it was to 500, I would get a million of these little points in here and you'd be here all day trying to edit that stuff. Now it's just a matter of setting up your audio in the right spot. Tip number 10, if you haven't already guessed, you can zoom in on the auto track to make precise edits. Here's how. Back in my video editor, I can see I have some sound waves in here, the frequency spectrum, and I can see all my edit points, but it sure is hard to know when my voice here is going to line up with a guitar. So here's an easy way to do it. You can take this and zoom in a lot more so you can see exactly when the sound waves are happening. So for example, my voice starts right here. So that's when I want the guitar to play. So I can actually line things up much easier with this tool. Then I can simply grab these edit points and drag them down until I get a nice gradual approach on the audio. Of course, if you get too many edit points, you can delete these things, get a little bit, I don't know, easier in control over the ramp up, whatever you want to call it. That way, when I'm moving my cursor back and forth and playing it,
the pipe length longer for insertion into the fitting.
There you go. Nice little tip on making your audio levels a lot larger so you can see exactly where your peaks and your dead spots are in your audio. Thanks for watching these 5 tips on Adobe Premiere Elements. Stay tuned, there's more to come. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, please give me a thumbs up.